What's up, everyone? Bearkid here, and I'm bringing you guys a quick Gears of War 4 update video. I'm going to be talking about the October update that's actually going to be releasing as of Monday. I just wanted to go a little bit into my personal feelings about this because it's honestly disappointing. I'll be honest with you right now. I'm not even going to sugarcoat it. The major thing that everyone is pissed about, and I mean they're pissed about it. Look at the video, official video here, the like and the dislike bar. Dislikes are destroying that video right now, and you know, it's obviously everyone is pissed, not just me, not just certain players. A lot of people are pissed off, and I don't blame them. So basically what's going on is, when it came to the last two maps, these are the final two maps that we're going to be getting for the series, for this game, obviously. It's a part of the season pass, and after this, there's no more new maps. So you know, everyone's thinking, you know, everyone kind of had of a high expectation for it, thinking that we're going to get some good maps. You know, this is the final two for the game, and then that's it. You know, we better get something good, right? So, yes and no. So, first we got Fuel Depot, which obviously is, you know, a good classic map. Personally, I'm tired of getting the classic maps that have been in previous Gears of War games. If you're going to give us classic maps, give us maps that were only in that game, a map that was only in Gears of War 1, or only in Gears of War 2, or only in Gears of War 3, a map that hasn't been in a lot of the games. And, you know, that's what I was really hoping for, but we got Fuel Depot. I mean, I kind of have mixed feelings for it. I always liked Fuel Depot, always thought it was a good map, but it, you know, it's okay. I'll just say that it's good enough. But the reason why people are pissed is because of the second map we got, which was simply Lift Apex. Another version of Lift that's outside instead of, you know, inside, and it has the sun and everything. The major difference is the fact that the map has these shutters now. When you go inside of the map to pick up the boom shot, you can push the buttons and it closes the shutters and makes a little bit more dynamic when it comes to fighting and forcing people to fight more on the inside instead of lantering from the outside. Cool idea, you know, not bad. But this isn't what we wanted when it came to the final two maps for the games. First, we get a Gears of War map that's been in multiple Gears of War games, and then we get a remake of yet another map that was already on Gears of War 4. So, of course, people are pissed. I don't blame them. I'm not happy about it. And when I saw it, my literal reaction was, well, at least we got one map, because Lift doesn't count. And it really doesn't. That's the thing that really sucks, because when it came to Gears of War, the one thing that really was strong about it, one major strong suit, is it always had really dynamic, unique, and amazing maps that came out for its DLC. I mean, amazingly, Gears of War 2 had a shitload of maps. Like, every single time you would go into that game, you're hearing about a new map pack, and the maps that came out for it were really cool, really interesting, and honestly, were my favorite amount of maps. Like, there's like a crazy amount of maps, and just the maps themselves were amazing. Like, I will always love the Gears of War 2 style, and the maps and everything came out. My all-time favorite map is actually Allfather's Garden in Gears of War 2, and unfortunately that never came back. That was never in Gears of War 3, and not gonna be in Gears of War 4 now, and it really sucked to know that I'm probably never gonna ever get to play that map ever again, in the new game at least. And that's the thing that really sucks when it comes to Gears of War 4, because we're not really getting new maps. We're just getting remakes from previous games or remakes from the same game. And that's the thing that's really disappointing, because when you compare the diversity and the uniqueness of maps from Gears of War 2 to Gears of War 4, it's night and day. It's night and day. And even the same with Gears of War 3, because Gears of War 3, yeah, had maps from previous games, you know, but it still had a lot of new maps. You know, when you got a map pack, you got a bunch of new maps, and you're like, holy shit, this is new, you know, this is awesome. But when Gears of War 4, it's like, I can't even imagine how many maps that we have that are actually unique to the game, that are brand new. I think it's probably like 5 or something like that, a really low number. And then the rest are basically remakes from Gears of War 2, Gears of War 3, Gears of War 1, and Gears of War 4, which is kind of sad. But I definitely understand why people are pissed, because it is really sad, and it just sucks to know that we're not getting, you know, what we really wanted. And pretty much besides the maps, there isn't really any major updates to the game itself, at least as far as I can see. I could put a link in the description, you guys can check it out. But overall, it's not really anything too crazy besides just those two maps. And it kind of made me wonder why we had to wait this long for the new maps, if it was just going to be these two. You know, I said the other thing that came to mind the other day when I was thinking about it, is why are they taking so long to make the maps? And then I see them today, and I'm like, okay, like, if they're going to make us wait, they should have at least gave us something worth waiting for. But overall, guys, go ahead and let me know what you guys think. Go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe if you guys like this video. Honestly, not really happy with the coalition. You know, come on, guys. Gears of War has always been really unique and diverse and, you know, had kind of like the I don't give a fuck what other games are like, I'm my own style of game type of attitude. And now it just seems like morally it's kind of catering to the competitive end, to the point that we're getting, you know, microtransactions and even maps that are just more competitive that are simply the same maps we already had. Which is kind of stupid because of the fact that if you're going to make maps like Impact, Dark, Lift, Apex, or Reclaim the Windflare, it might as well at least be not included in the Season Pass. You know what I mean? Not something that just a free update or a free addition and not taken out of the maps that we paid for, or wanted to pay for, whatever the heck you want to call it, because the Season Pass is kind of pointless too, to be honest. I'm not going to even get into that discussion. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching and take it easy. Thanks for watching this video. If you want to see my most recent Gears of War video, hit that link on the left. If you want to see any of my other content, hit that link on the right. Thanks for watching, guys.